Hello and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 3. And where we left off, we were about to invade Poland, and well, as always, there is a description or a link in the description to download the mod, and I think we're about ready to go. I'm pretty happy with how things are looking. I'm a little bit upset that we haven't got a slightly higher officer ratio, but it's fine. It's at 100%, and for the purposes of dealing with Poland, it shouldn't be a problem. But we lose free neutrality, Canada loses some neutrality, the USA gains some, which is a bit of a shame, but Belgium and the Netherlands gain it as well, and that's key. That's going to be a massive thing. So let's hit that. Danzig or war. We choose war, and hopefully that has, yeah, so that's bought us a little bit of time with the Dutch. So now that we are at war, that allows us a little bit more freedom with our production, and maybe we should reassess our laws. So I think it's probably worth going over to this now to get the ruling party support. We can go to service by requirement, maybe? I don't like the minus 15% on resources, so no, we're going to do 3-year draft. Heavy industry emphasis. Okay, and then the other options were emergency conscription. I think we're fine to keep it on normal for now. Because, yeah, we don't need that much manpower. So yeah, that'll do. We've got some fleet events, so okay, redirect our manpower. Now we haven't got a huge amount of manpower to do, and to be completely honest, none of these bonuses really appeal right now, so we're going to say no to that. Blitzkrieg. Okay, let's start with the medium ships event. So we're going to take what we can, and then does that spawn them in the production queue? It does. So let's chuck those guys to the top. Because if needs be, they're going to be emergency transports for Norway. We're going to trigger the home front event, which is going to increase our descent a little bit. And then we're going to chuck on Blitzkrieg. So, losses in crude oil and leadership and IC, but territorial pride up, combat movement speed. Yeah, I might as well just do it, to be honest. So we're going to say yes to that. Okay. And let's have a little look at our air forces and the like and get things up and running. So we're going to want to sort of give each area its own sort of defensive position that it needs to hold on to. So yeah, let's air intercept missions with all of our fighters. Ooh, this music is not the best for this sort of... Oh no, so foreboding. Oh shit. And we're doing these air intercept missions on purpose to try and defend our factories from those British strategic bombers that we know are going to be turning up relatively soon. In Ansbach. Because we've got a fair amount of, like, tank factories and the like that we're going to want to defend. God, I have got a huge air force. I didn't realize I'd built this many planes. I very much doubt the British are going to be able to easily bomb our factories, that's for sure. Because we need to defend our metal production. Right, I very much doubt they're going to head this far in this direction, but better to be safe than sorry. Yeah, you guys are for the defense of Berlin itself. Yeah, and then we've got a couple of different groups for the defense of Leipzig. And we've got to defend the Skoda Works as well. Okay, so I think that's all of our air. Oh, no. Munich. Nearly forgot Munich. Yeah, we've got to defend the Heartland as well. Now, you guys, I'm not necessarily expecting to start doing your missions immediately. You can probably hold off for a little bit. And then, yes, Vienna. Nearly forgot. Very nearly. Okay, and then, yes, all of our planes for the invasion of Poland. Now, how do we want to best do this? You guys, I think we should do a ground attack with. I think we should take all of our close air support and do a ground attack mission all along the front there. And then I'm looking at an air superiority mission, I think, over here. Yeah, so that's all of you ready to go. Yes, and then in the south, let's do some air superiority as well. So here, here, and here. I think you should go start at this one and then go the other direction. Now, I would imagine our fighter planes are going to have an extremely easy job handling this, but you never know, they might not. And then again, yeah, let's punch through with our close air support all along the front there. Ground attack with those guys. And yeah, we've got a lot of planes to do air support in the south with. In fact, you guys get the Warsaw area. Oh yeah, and we have another group of planes, yep, for being pushed back just a little bit further in that direction. Okay, and then finally, yeah, we've got the East Prussia area. So I think we want to do air superiority of our planes heading towards Bret-Litovsk. And heading towards Warsaw. And then, yeah, we've got our medium bombers. Now, with those guys, do we have any specific targets that we want to try and attack? No, let's just do a general ground attack mission with them, and then I think the same thing with you guys. Okay, so that's all of the air forces dealt with. Navy. Let's start doing a bit of convoy raiding on a passive mission. Only go for things where we think we're going to make some progress. And I think, yeah, another raiding mission over here. Perfect. Three groups should be fine for now. You're already moving out and you're about to get into position. And then we can immediately attack with our infantry. So Let's take... Yeah, the light divisions and head that way. And then let's take you... We'll probably leave you behind because you're not that useful. And then I'm not going to do anything fancy with like planning on this one. We're just going to do a straight attack. All across the front. Okay, so, battles have begun. Now, our bombings are all going ahead, I think, across the front. I don't think we're quite at war with the French, are we? Oh, no, we are. What about, yeah, so we are with the British as well. Okay, so we've won the Battle of Roggenzo. So, 1,800 casualties. They are going to melt in front of us. Including, I think... Yeah. Right, so victories all across the front then. Not bad going. Okay, and some commercial agreements and things. So our copper trade, I think, or yeah, our chromite trade has ended. We can get the armored designs. Yeah, we definitely want to do that. So expand tank factories, hit the steps in, fine. We want to expand an airbase, sure. We can ask the Soviets for the... So, what do we get out of this? The opportunity to ask the Soviets to sign the agreement. They will send us 5% of our... global resources in exchange for 1% IC. Yeah, why not? Ooh, we get some crude oil. We're out of supplies. That's a bit of a problem. Oh no. Come on. What is going on here? Right, that'll have to do for our production at the moment. Okay, so auxiliary vessels. We're going to chuck all of you into Kiel for now because we don't need to worry about having you in place right this second. And we haven't got a leader for the 50th Infantry Division. Let's just chuck in a basic guy that's got an armoured group. 3rd Panzer can move straight on. As can the Kampfgruppe. And let's take the HQ south. And then everyone else can just keep on heading through. This will be a very quick war if all goes to plan. I didn't move you guys out, but let's support attack there like so. Let's break through here and do a support attack with this unit. I think over the river here. And we are being counterattacked in that one position. And we've got the option to buy chromite from Turkey. We're going to do that again. And I don't like the massive drop-off we had there. There we go, that's better. Okay, and I imagine that we will very quickly overrun the Poles. In fact, I think it's already happened in a few spots. Let's take you up that way, and then everyone else. Can head like so, up and around. Oh, that was a town. But we are being counterattacked. Just a little bit. Not a massive amount, but enough for it to be slightly disconcerting. And I expected more out of you, the 30th Infantry. Is that really the best you can do? They are in possession of a tank division over here, which is a bit of a slight problem, but only minor. Von Foma is advancing quite nicely. Some awesome mud effects apparently happening at the moment, but I don't think that's going to be a problem for our invasion of Poland. Whoa! And that's why our coastal submarines are pretty shit. Oh, God. All three of them, really? Jesus. Right, now how's the... So, after the crash as a result of the great evil that is the air map mode... I'm just deciding that I'm not going to press this button anymore. But, you know, we're going to keep an eye out just to make sure that we're not being attacked at all. But things are looking okay at the moment. We're moving slowly into Poland. Well, I say slowly. It's quite quick. Bulgaria has taken steps to align itself to the Axis. Ooh, very nice. And slowly but surely, the Americans are heading on over. Did some decent damage to us there, actually, for a second. Interesting. Right, and we can surround them now from a couple of different directions. We've got a couple of encirclements on the way. We need to take Turun over here. But we've got an encirclement in the south, and I am actively moving out to try and encircle in this direction as well. A couple of forces. But it's a relatively easy breakthrough so far. Taking Poland as Germany is always an extremely easy feat. Or at least it should be. Our production queue has ground to a bit of a halt. We're only doing the stuff at the top and up to the submarines, which is a bit of a shame, but should be okay. We're just dealing with a little bit of negative IC impact from divisional upgrades at the moment. Okay, and let's take our units forward. And I think our runway cratering missions can finish there. Let's switch to Warsaw and do the damage to their planes on the ground over there. Yeah, looks like we're taking out their planes on the ground, which is lovely. Getting a little bit of the Polish leadership now, which is very good. Up to 1939, and Denmark is mobilizing? What do you think you're doing, Denmark? Their neutrality is zero, but they're not very close to the Allies, and they're only moving very slowly towards them, so... oh, Italy is trying to get Norway into the Axis, which is kind of cool. Okay, and yeah, the one thing I didn't do was I didn't do my convoy raiding. Oopsie daisy, I should have done that a minute ago. Let's get that party started. can leave you behind to allow for the push out in this direction. And yeah, a massive encirclement there and another decent size encirclement here. And yeah, we could even go for one here as well. So you know what, let's try and go for that as well, rather than at Turun. Okay, we are struggling at Sulvaki, which isn't the best. We might as well push out now for the invasion or the ending of Warsaw. Hopefully we can finish off enough of these planes on the ground to cause a bit of a problem. Yeah, looks like the damage is being done. In fact, the loss of their planes might even just be based out of Warsaw and this. Yeah, I can't see that they've got planes in any other airfield, so we might have finally done it. Oh. So the British trying to strategically bomb at Nordhorn, which is a bit of a pain. There's an encirclement as well. So we've got an encirclement at Danzig, an encirclement at Cyzin, I think, and then an encirclement based around Poznan. Very nice. We are happy with this. And we are wasting a little bit more on production. But we're putting that into supply production just so that we're keeping our forces nice and well supplied in this invasion. Right, come on, finish the job. We can take you that way. You can head this way. All of our motorized divisions are all moving up towards Warsaw itself. And there are five divisions stuck in the Seastern pocket, which is quite a lot. That's a decent whack of divisions we've managed to catch there. And yeah, the damage has definitely been done with our air force first and foremost. Right, and then yeah, we can use some of our units around here as well. Another one of our planes up and running. Level 3, but yeah, we need level 2 commanders. We've run out of level 3 commanders. The Air Force has got a lot of decent commanders in place. Okay. And you'd think that they would have probably gone by now, but apparently not. I would have thought that these planes would have been dealt with, but doesn't look like that is indeed the case. Now, we do want to try and keep this war going for a pretty decent amount of time, to be completely honest. And we want to do that on purpose, purely because we want to get as much experience as we can as possible. So let's make sure that we don't just rush it, as much as that would be a very easy thing to do. Now, the cav division is definitely holding us in place. And there's another opportunity for an encirclement here. So you know what? We're actually going to take Kleist to the south. And then close up this pocket around Krakow as well. And then hopefully we can do another one around Warsaw. They're not close to surrendering just yet. So that's kind of a good thing. That shows that they've got a little bit of bite about them. And we continue to take our troops to the south. We can take our motorized HQs into that conscript division. Yeah, and there wasn't any major battles in that area that we had to worry about. And yeah, that battle at Krakow is slightly tough. Ever so slightly tough. Let's do an encirclement operation around here. Yeah, we are definitely beating that infantry division into submission. And I think we just managed to surround and capture another couple of divisions. The Poznan pocket has been dealt with. We might as well begin our final advance on Danzig. Danzig's got a decent number of divisions in there, and they're of decent quality. They're not completely useless. So hopefully we'll get some decent experience out of that. It's not 100% a walkover, this. Like, the Poland AI is doing slightly better than the Poland AI normally does. Although the Soviets have just come in, so that's going to... that's going to signal curtains. But we have managed to encircle them sort of all over the front. And Thielsen is moving on up into his last position. It's going to take our units a bit of time to... wow. Britain! Jesus. Worrying. And then I think we've got a decent surround now of the Warsaw capital. So Poland's capital, they have got 8 units of completely broken down infantry in place. And a single garrison unit. Not exactly the stuff of legend. Can actually attack with the infantry division from the other side just to speed up that battle. Just to make sure that there isn't going to be any retreat for them. There is some marshland, actually. In fact, let's take you, Ger von Schweckenberg, and move you out into this area here. Just so that we surround that infantry division and destroy it. And there we go. Full encirclement in the south. There's another cav division that we need to probably finish up with. And some of our infantry can take this cav unit out. So we've got a victory point at Krakow that we need to take. We've got a victory point at Warsaw and a victory point at Danzig that we'll need to handle. And we're getting a naval bombardment, shore bombardment penalty buff as well, which is good. We've got another air combat at Dusseldorf, or Dusseldorf. We are sadly taking a little bit of IC damage even with all of our air intercept missions going. But we will have another fighter plane group that we can probably send to Cologne. Or we could send them, yeah, to Erzgikin. Oh my god. Pronunciation. Terrible. Definitely not what I'm good for. I am, and I've say it again, I am the Rich Evans of Hearts of Iron 3 Black Ice. Okay, yet another pocket. Okay, I was expecting some sort of counterattack, and haha! We just got the, yes, marine activation. Now, what we want to immediately jump over to is landing craft flotillas. I imagine that this will be a pretty quick tech for us. Yep, we're going to get it this year. Perfect. Because we want to start building up our tech on that front quite quickly. We've beaten that garrison unit back. Oh, you tricky bastards. Well, that's not acceptable. And we might as well carry on with our push into Krakow. Fully surrounded. Danzig's going to put up more of a defense, I reckon, than Warsaw, to be completely honest. And we did manage to get one of our units encircled, but we will quickly handle that. That's what happens when you go just a little bit too quickly into something. And the Soviets are definitely making their way over as well quite quickly. Oh, another encirclement over here as well. Very nicely done. Okay, Beck can attack that army position there. Something like this wouldn't be awful. Okay, and then finally, let's take our divisions and do a surround attack into Warsaw. Should be a relatively quick and straightforward battle, I'd reckon. Oh, that's a decent garrison, actually. A lot of these units are going to break quite quickly, but the three units of garrison, they won't immediately be taken out. And, ah, there we go. Krakow just went in our favour, which is good. After a pretty hard-fought battle. Hopefully you got some decent experience out of that. Jesus, we are losing coastal battleship, or coastal subs like no one's business. That is not good. Decent tank division here. They're trying to hold a line, I think, based around Grondo. So, it's a strange one. As I say, the Poland AI has done a lot better than it normally does, but, I mean, obviously against a well-coordinated assault like this, they're not gonna survive for long. But they have more units than they normally do, so I don't know if that's as a result of, like, 10.4. or if that's something else, but still very interesting. And yeah, let's get around the flank. This is going to be another encirclement over here as well. Not bad, not bad at all. Okay, we're not sending the coastal submarines out. Jesus. Yuan, yeah, we will definitely let you buy a fighter plane. If it keeps you in the war, for sure. Just Guiyang that's left now. Although it says it's 78.2, so do you own some other victory provinces anywhere? Is it literally just Guiyang that's keeping you in this? If it is, I'll be shocked. It must be. Interesting. Oh! You own Beijing again. Ah, okay. That's part of it as well. Well done, China. You've lasted till nearly 1940. That's not bad at all. Fuck you, Japan. You failed me for the last time. We're going with America this time. There's our victory elsewhere confirmed. Aha, Warsaw. So yeah, we need to take Danzig. Which again has a pretty sizable garrison in it. To be honest, we can probably think about not even bothering moving any more units up, to be honest. Might as well get a bit of experience at prep, whatever it's called. We're only losing fuel at the moment, and that's only because of conversion. So that's good. We're still in the green for all of our other stuff. We've got enough officers by which to replenish our losses and then exceed them. We're still funneling a lot into supply, just for a little bit longer. And yet another encirclement. Left of their forces have been pretty much easily handled in Danzig. Come on. It's been pretty easy. Pretty easy. Nothing horrific to deal with here. And we're going to be finishing this war about the same time as it really occurred, I reckon. Because by taking out Danzig, I think Danzig is worth how many? Yeah, 5. So Danzig's worth more than Warsaw. Oh, interesting. I didn't realise that. And all of the remaining Polish air units fled to that airbase. So I think that's the end of Poland. Yep. Okay. So in one day, we'll have finished that. Okay, so Polish Corridor. And Foul Vice. So there we go, that's the end of Poland. Not a bad job. Pretty well done, I think, all things considered. I think we exceeded our expectations for how we thought we would do in this campaign, so I'm pretty happy. The Poles didn't really stand much of a chance, but I will give Poland this. They actually marshalled their forces to defend the cities, which is more than Poland normally does, but it did bag us a little bit more experience. So definitely not going to complain too badly about that. We can have a look at what we managed to inherit then. So we got some... Oh, victory music! Yep, so I think we're just sinking the Polish Navy right now. Let's take you in that direction, and we can take you over to the southern Baltic to maybe act as a defensive position. And we're going to honour the pact for sure. And get our units the hell out of Soviet territory. So we could probably bring everyone back into their respective army positions in a moment. We don't want to use more fuel than we have to. But yeah, let's see what we got. So we got a artillery factory, small arms factory, and a capital or a medium shipyard and a small shipyard, which isn't that bad. There's another small shipyard there. What else? Nothing in Poznan. Sadly. Lodz? Nope. An artillery factory here. A small plane factory there. Krakow? Nope, nothing. Warsaw's a pretty large nation, like, sort of state there, actually. You get a decent amount of stuff out of just taking Warsaw, so I think Warsaw was the major improvement that we got there. So with that then, we can start finishing our plane orders. Anyone that's doing air superiority, they need to stop. There's no point wasting the fuel. Yeah, like you. No, thank you. You can stop attacking Warsaw, please. Oh, and another victory over there. Let's keep on sinking some of their ships with the Scharnhorst and Gneisenau. We don't want any of their ships to make it to British ports. And our Emden-Boston convoy. There shouldn't be an Emden... Ah, okay, right. We say no to you. I think that was, yeah, that was the only trade that was going outside of Europe. Okay, let's have a little look at our tech situation, because I heard the sound of the tech updating. So hangar bay maintenance at 1940, we'll let that run. Okay, and we are in the middle of doing some armor techs as well ahead of time. AFE tracks and suspension should be finishing up very quickly. Assault guns, yeah, so November 8th for that, which is very good. So I think, yeah, we've pretty much done everything that we wanted to do. Let's get the first army together. Let's get the first Panzer army together. Let's get the second Panzer army together. And the second army together. Oh, I see you. You shouldn't be running any missions. Neither should you. Ooh, naval combat. Ah, this is the end of the... hopefully the end of the combats. Poland, come on. Keep sinking their navy. We're going to hunt them down step by step. Okay, and we've got the options to do a little bit of extra stuff over here. So, synthetic plant. Okay, so industry at least 5, supplies at least 18,000, okay. And, yeah, we'll sure. Coal liquidation technology. Okay, that must be a hidden tech or something. So, we do want the 72nd division. We do want to create the Greater Deutschland, the Ferdenhalle, and the 22nd Luftlander. Why not? Some air combat in Dresden that we can easily handle. We need to prepare now for the invasion of France. That's going to be the next key metric that we're going to need to, define ourselves by. Have you managed to find... Come on. No. Yeah. They haven't found it. Come on. Get them. Okay, well, if you're not going to get them, then we do have some naval bombers that we can use to naval strike. And that is what we shall do instead. Ah, that found them. There we go. That's what we like. And there we go. Victory. And it's purely some submarines and the like that are left. Keep on going, and in fact, we can take the naval bombers and send them up to the other area to grab. We really want to kill off the submarines. Kill off the entire Polish navy. If we can. Ooh, that felt like a lot of events. And it was indeed a lot of events. So this is where we're going to end off the episode after we've done these. So, we're going to get back the Greater German Reich. The Polizei Division, sure. We will establish this training base. And I wonder... Yeah, that's going to give that over to the British. I don't know why that happens when you establish that training base. We will do the trade agreement. Tank factory, yep, great. Tannenberg, sure. We will build another tank factory there, we do want that. And I don't think we need to do scrap metal or fuel, so we're going to say no on both of those counts. And, yeah, where were you? You were something, weren't you? One of you has got... Yeah, you. You're the one that I want. Because we're going to chuck that into here. That specialized light infantry. And yeah, you're not the best for getting to that. And neither are you. We need a single division for the purposes of reclaiming. Ah, right. Perfect. Off you go, mountain troops. I'll give you a commander as well, just to speed you up ever so slightly. Right, come on, finish off your naval strike. Right, fate of France. So, sounds like a good idea. We don't need Heeresgruppe Nord. A supply bonus actually wouldn't be the worst thing. Yeah, we'll build the Alderhorst. Henschelen Schon, yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm not against this one actually. Let's grab that. And just finish off the last of these Polish submarines. Hopefully. Including that Polish transport ship. And yeah, that does get us Lodz, but it doesn't get us Warsaw, sadly, included in that deal. Oh well. But we do get some extra capital ships and the like. Right, come on. Finish the job. You're getting a little bit of experience. Okay, and the last party congress. So we need to do chromite trade. So we lose industry in Nordhorn, but we gain synthetic. That's fine. Armored research designs. Does that update AFE? It does. Very nice. Create them. Coal rationing. We do not need that. And then the last of our too bad for peace events. Right. AFE tracks at 42. Not bad, and then we're just waiting, I think, on the completion of some of the anti-tank roles one here. Yep. Good, good, good. And we need to keep on updating. The German or the French don't seem like they think that they can push over into our defensive positions, which is very nice. Good to know. Okay, we're going to send you that way, and then we're going to reinforce this with that division. And we do want to buy chromite from Turkey, so we're going to take that. And that's a... that's just a train, isn't it? I don't think we need it. And I'm just gonna wait for you. Come on. Where are you, Yodel? You son of a bitch. Right. Yeah, 18 hours. Perfect. Because then we can detach that specialized light infantry and chuck it in over here as well. And then they'll all have the same basic template layout, which is good. I would say yes, actually, to this. Oh, we got a delete. Oh, an elite HQ. Perfect. For the Fortress Busters. That's what we wanted that for. We're already planning for our invasion of the Soviet Union by getting these Fortress Busters nice and early. And yeah, some more of our units coming online. Get you out of Dodge. And oh, this is like the little health land over here. Right, we did lose a little bit of manpower there, and the Goering 4-year plan continues. So I think we should get, yeah, definitely another veteran HQ if we can. And then, okay, so year 3. Lose 5,000 supply, lose 8,000 metal, lose 5,000 energy, lose 500 rare materials, but gain industry, heavy industry, and 50 manpower, sure. That is fine by me, and then, yep, a veteran HQ as well that we can move up into these units. And speaking of veteran HQs, where is Yodel? Yep, we want that elite light infantry, please. For our Fortress Busters. And I think, as I say, this is probably the best time to call it an episode. So thank you very much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in episode, well, what number are we on now? Is this 9? I think it'll be episode 9, where hopefully we can maybe think about starting to plan for the invasion of Norway and Denmark, as well as planning out the invasion of the Netherlands. Their neutrality has already dropped off the edge of a cliff. And I imagine that they're going to be able to join the Axis really quickly. Or, sorry, join the Allies really quickly. So it's a good job that we did put some defences over here. But I am worried about what that means in general from now on out. But thank you very much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Thanks again. Bye-bye.